Hello guys and welcome to The Bro Thing, your favorite spot for all the pickup and dating related information. So today I'd like to talk about why most of the people who are starting out, you know, who are beginners or even intermediate people, have a lot of failed approaches. So watch this video till the end, because towards the end I'll share a simple strategy which increased my results tenfold after I applied it to my life. Now guys, I see a lot of people, you know, struggling in pickup without even realizing anything about this issue. Now for me, the single idea of being full-hearted towards every approach in life has helped me acquire a bulletproof mindset. Now this is not only towards every girl I'm approaching, but towards anything I'm approaching in life, whether it's a new business, whether it's a new skill, and this has really helped me in my business and my life. Now what I see most people doing is approaching girls and being completely half-hearted towards the approach, and it looks something like this.
Excuse me. Hi, I just saw you like there and I really like your glasses. I want to come say hi.
Thank you so much.
Which brand is it?
Lenskart.
Really? I thought it was like a Oakley or, you know, you were going to tell me some fancy brand. So like, have you tried lenses as against... No, we're not marketing. I just thought you look cute. I wanted to come say hi. Anyway, have a good one.
It seems as if he's not certain, he's shit nervous, and almost as if he's forced to do the approach. Now, there are some rules to the game, and these rules, if applied correctly, can help you become more full-hearted towards every approach that you're doing. And if you use this analogy in any area of your life, you'll reap massive results. So it is quite simple if you think about it. The idea is to do and not to try. It's also more about how you do what you do rather than what you do. For example, in theory, you know, it's more about how you open, whether you're smiling, whether you're nervous, how you're feeling when you're opening, rather than the opener itself. So in order to be full-hearted, first you have to be really present to the moment, which means that you have to be more focused on the now and enjoy the conversation with the girl than to be in your head where you're constantly thinking, hey, what's the next best thing to say? How do I take her home? Am I being physical enough? Now, when you are out in the field and when you're trying to pick up some girls and you're just thinking about the next step, about the next move, the next line, you will not be full-hearted and you will not be fully invested in the conversation, as you're either living in the worries of the future or the worries of the past. Like, oh, did I say something wrong? Or what's the perfect comeback to this? And what ends up happening is, you know, you're not really enjoying the present moment. That is, you're not really enjoying the conversation that you're holding with this beautiful girl and she notices it. It should always be like you have this burning desire for the woman and you want it to take it to the end. Even if it's a rejection. Now, I see a lot of guys going out there approaching girls just to get the validation or some good reactions. Now, you have to understand, if you're learning pickup, you're not doing it properly because you're worried about what other people might think. You're not being full-hearted. Now, when I'm doing pickup, my reticulation activation system, which is just my focus, is only towards the girl. And it's like everything around us just completely disappears until there's a cock block, of course. Now, when I'm super focused on the girl, she's super focused on me. And sometimes, even if her friends pop up, right, rather than me being cock blocked, she just pushes them off.
Shake it, shake it. What you gonna do?
Hey, man. Nice to see you.
Another thing you would want to do is when you are in the field, when you hit the field, try to minimize your time between interactions. So when you are in the field, you act like a shark, right? You're always approaching the next target, the next thing that comes along, the next person that comes along. Now in the mentorship program, I break down one full night where you can see me and my wing did about 30 approaches. And at that time, we're not really counting, you know, this is approach number one, this is approach number two. We're just like bloodthirsty sharks who are approaching the whole place, the whole club, and having massive fun while doing it. Now at that time, you know, I'm completely in the present moment. I'm enjoying each approach, even the rejections. And it looks something like this. Now, taking this advice, also use your common sense. And by that, I mean, if you're in a conservative spot, you don't want to get banned, it's better you keep shifting your locations as well. As you can see, you know, when we're doing those 30 approaches, we're on the street, but we're constantly shifting our locations from point A to point B. Now, in my case, it's a really smooth approach because I've been doing game for a long time. But if you are a beginner, you don't want to be creeping a lot of girls out on the same spot. And I'm hoping since you're watching these videos, that shouldn't be the case with you. But understand the importance of shifting the location. Because if you don't, and a lot of girls, you know, see you doing this back to back, they will, complain, or they will tell the people to kick you out of the club, and that will happen. The only reason I'm able to do back-to-back approaches is because when I go out in the field, I'm not wasting my time smoking a cigarette, you know, ordering some food or just talking to my wing. Because when I start my first approach, it's always back-to-back approach, and I want you to see how this looks. So I even approach one girl in front of a girl I've already approached, and the only reason I can do this is because, you know, I've been doing this for a long time. And once I'm in the field, you know, in one infield I saw, I just do 4 to 5 approaches in about 7 minutes. I want you to check it out.
Nice to meet you. That looks like a real name.
Now, with that kind of a mindset, you will learn game a lot faster. And I know a lot of people who are learning pickup who waste a lot of time when they're in the field. Now, I remember doing this too earlier, but when I stopped and I acted like, you know, there's a clock ticking, as soon as I hit the field, my results went up. Even, you know, the game sessions were really good. Because earlier, you know, when I used to do practice cold approach pickup in Singapore, I had about 7 to 8 hours to do, you know, to practice the art of cold approach. But in India, if you're going to a bar, it usually shuts down at 1 a.m. until and unless you are in a club, in a 5-star hotel or something, right? Unlike 5 a.m. in Singapore. I live 1 hour away from the city. So I have to, you know, get ready, take my car, go to the city. It takes me 1 hour. And my daily gaming session is about 2.5 hours or two to three hours, right? So I used to reach the gaming location at around 10 and game till like 1 a.m. And I realized because I had little time on my hands, I have to do more approaches. And because of this, I was approaching a lot more. I used to even get more results than when I was approaching back for say 7 to 8 hours. So I can say proudly that I was getting in more results in 2 to 3 hours than 7 to 8 hours. So the amount of time you put in does not matter, but what matters is what you do in that time. Now, once you are in the present moment, right? You're in the present moment, you're minimizing the time between sets, you're talking to a lot of different people. What is the next thing to do? The next thing to do is be certain in all your approaches. And I see this, you know, with a lot of guys who are new to this, or not even new, a lot of guys who are intermediate. The guys go in for the open, but they're not certain, they're not masculine in their open. And if you're half-hearted, guys, it won't work, because the girls get creeped out when some fucking scrub comes up, approaches them, grabs their arm like that. And mostly, right, you're just not certain enough. You're kind of uncertain. You don't know whether she's gonna comply to you or not. And what happens is, I also see a lot of guys, you know, being incongruent, which means trying to fake masculinity. So remember, guys, you know, if you want to go up to a girl, if you want to talk to a girl, you want to be chill and chatty, go up, be chill and chatty. But if you want to go up, you want to be strong and dominant, then go up, be strong and dominant. Do not mix up the frames, because mixing up the frames shows incongruence at your part and uncertainty. This is also the reason most of the physicality fails. And to be honest, you know, if you're half-hearted and you're trying to be physical with a girl, most of the times it means that you're unsure of your move, all right? And you're going to make the girl highly uncomfortable because she's going to notice that you're half-hearted and you're not full-hearted. Maybe you're doing it because you have to do it and you're not really enjoying it. And then they start pointing it out. And I've seen this so many times, right? I've been out with wings and this has happened with me as well, right? The girl will just point it out. Hey, how are you touching me? Why are you touching me? And at this point, it's best to back off, but realize this happened because either you're not sure, right? You're not sure of holding her hand and you still did it, being nervous, being half-hearted, and she realized that you're a scrub. So that can be the case. Now, whenever I'm going out to game, I'm always, you know, forcing myself to be full-hearted. Even if sometimes I'm feeling that, hey, listen, you know, I'm not feeling in the momentum, I'm not feeling in the vibe, I'm always pushing myself to be full-hearted. I'm always going for the hard stop and I go in with all certainty. I believe that she's gonna stop when I tell her to stop. She's not gonna walk. But if she does walk, I'm not gonna eject. I walk with her. I take the lead. I analyze the situation. I decide my next step in a split second decision. And I'm not waiting there thinking that, hey, if she's not, you know, if she's moving, I should eject, right? I focus and I zone in on the girl. And that is what you should do too. Even if the girl is unattractive, guys, and that is the great point, that is the key, right? Every set, you have to train your mindset to be focused in every particular set, even if you're not attracted to the girl. Now, another great point that comes to my mind because of all of this is you have to understand, in pickup, we say assume value and assume attraction, and it's always good to assume it, but girls don't know that you're that cool guy just by your opener, right? And I firmly believe that more the girl talks to me, the more comfortable she is with me, the more attracted she gets. So assume attraction, that's all okay. Be high value, but still be able to, you know, willing to take action and do whatever is required to move the social interaction forward. And if you really want to go deeper in this, I would also suggest you remove all of your comfort cushions that stop you from falling to ground zero. Now, I remember my first tour, right? It was Delhi, Bangalore, and Mumbai. Now, I met this girl in Bangalore who I really connected well with. And I was already in Mumbai. I was doing my boot camp in Mumbai and I was a bit more relaxed, more chilled out. And I was not doing that game as aggressively as I should have just because I had a comfort cushion to land on. I knew even if nothing works out with this girl, I might not see her again because she's from Austria, right? She was visiting India. But in the back of my mind, I always knew if I don't pull a girl tonight, I can go back and I can call her and just be comfortable. Now, this is also the case for a lot of people who start game and are still in a monogamous relationship. Because this holds you back a lot. You're unable to explore your full potential because in the back of your mind, you already have a comfort cushion. So for me, I figured out, you know, removing all these comfort cushions in order to be full-hearted really excelled my growth and realized that comfort kills your leverage to take action. What I mean is if you fall back to ground zero, you don't have any backups, you're bound to do better. You're bound to perform better because when you're out in the field, a big part of it is actually accepting and, you know, going against your fears. Now, if no one is there to talk to you tonight and then you don't have any comfort cushions, this will add fuel to your fire and grow a burning desire for you to take action. Now, another thing which I've spoken in the past is, so do not depend on the plan, but depend on yourself. Do not find comfort in anything, but try to addict yourself to uncomfortable situations. And this will really help you grow. And once you do addict yourself to those uncomfortable situations, approaching a mixed set will be like walk in the park for you. And I want to show you an infield, but before that, I'd also like to talk about the secret Facebook group that we have, where me and my team will personally help you in your pickup journey through answering your questions, sharing lessons every day, and value offering posts. Now, with that out of the way, let's get back to the infield.
Yo, guys, are you guys from Bangalore? We're searching for a good after party place. We have no fucking clue. This is my first day over here. And it's so shitty, dude. I thought Bangalore would be a metropolitan. It's so nice.
You think Bangalore is shitty?
It's okay. I mean, it's bad,
I don't
but.
Think so.
I know.
Yeah.
That's what I'm asking you.
You're from Dubai, man.
Dubai.
Dubai. Amazing.
Dubai, Dubai.
All of you?
Yeah. All of us.
All of us.
Allah.
Allah.
Ya Allah.
Ya Allah.
Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you. Arnav, man.
So you get my point of going towards resistance and constantly being out of your comfort zone to expand your comfort zone and for real growth. Now, another thing, guys, I realized while doing pickup, when you're half-hearted, what happens is you eject on the first bump that your conversation hits, right? Now, one thing you have to realize is pickup is very dynamic and that means that situations are ever changing. And you have to calibrate according to the situation, people around you. You have to respond to according to that. Now, both of these things are external. Now, the external cannot be controlled, all right? It is something that is out of your control. All you can control is your response to these situations. Now, I've seen many times, you know, that I was half-hearted. I would eject early and miss out the opportunities. For example, in my pull-in field, if you actually see it in the mentorship, you know, initially we decided that we're going to go down, eat some food, right? The plan changes as we go down. And if I was half-hearted, I would have ejected earlier. So watch this infield, it'll give you a better idea.
Stop that. Let's go. I live in a preschool, but I think we would enjoy that preschool.
It's not safe.
My friend is saying they're leaving. Stop that. Let's leave. Let her book it.
It's like you're from what, Mumbai.
Oh, you think he's gonna book the Uber
so
the other way?
You take the Uber.
Oh my god.
You're in the camps,
oh my god.
Right?
They think we're fucking molesters or some shit, dude.
Yeah, in Delhi.
Why?
Of course you are.
Yeah. Dude, as long as we are with each other, we'll book a cab. Oh my.
Don't worry.
Hey guys, let's go in.
Let me just see if
I'm
we're going to the preschool and from
I'm sitting there.
So you have to really understand that pickup is highly dynamic and it changes at each step of the game. And if you're half-hearted, you will eventually drop off the set during the first time that going gets tough. You know, if sets hit a bumpy road, you know, you'll eject. Now with all these examples, I hope you're able to hammer down these points in your head and you know, you'll surely be able to change your pickup game. Now before ending this video, I'd like to do a quick recap for the guys who might have missed something. So the first thing we spoke about is being full-hearted and taking each set, every set that you approach, all the way, right? Doesn't matter if you're not attracted to the girl. Now, another way of doing this is being present to the moment and enjoying each and every interaction that you're having with women. Also, being full-hearted in the field means to minimize, guys, understand this, minimize your time between your interactions. So if you're approaching a girl, you know, you get rejected, you gotta approach another one. Become a shark when you're in the field and be certain about, you know, whatever you're doing. Whether it's just walking from point A to point B, be certain, have a purpose, right? Whether it's opening a girl, be certain about it. Whether it's just vibing, whether you're trying to be physical with a girl, especially guys, if you're trying to be physical with a girl. And at the end, guys, realize, you know, kill all comfort cushions and keep expanding your comfort zone because comfort will kill your leverage to take action. This is Arunav signing off.